Hello learners, I am Dr. Sanjana Vij, Assistant Professor, Amity Institute of Education, New Delhi. I am going to take the topic for explaining you today is role of a teacher in environment education, expanding the child's universe. Now I will start my topic with a question that what is an environment? Environment literally means surrounding in which we are living, as it is clear by the name itself that it is a surrounding in which we are living, and it includes all those things on which we are directly or indirectly depends for our survival, whether it is for living components like animals, plants, or non-living components like air, water, soil, etc. So, natural world is very complex and human activities can have unexpected consequences that are hard to reverse. Therefore, the study of both physical and biological process that maintain life and how humans affect nature requires a broad interdisciplinary perspective. The core subjects at the primary stage of teaching learning includes languages, mathematics, and environmental studies. It is through the teaching and learning of EVS that the child is helped to understand the process and phenomena in the environment through integrating the spirit of science and social science subjects. So we can say that environmental education is the systematic study of the nature and man-made world. It has emerged as a major discipline in recent years, reflecting our growing concerns about the impact of human activity on the nature world. So that's why this environment education subject has become more important nowadays because of all these growing concerns. So further we should proceed, I would like to tell you that what is the basic education is all about. Basic education started by Mahatma Gandhi and can be regarded as one of the fundamental steps taken in the history of modern education in India. It relates education to the life needs and inspiration of the people. Two principles of basic education which are very relevant to environment education are, the first one is correlating the curriculum with the productive activity and with the social and physical environment of the child. The second one is intimate contact between school and community. So, what is the importance of environmental science? Environmental education is important not only because it informs us about the world in which we live, but also because it enables us to address more effectively many of the pressing issues that confront the modern world. So very, very important to have this environmental science in the syllabus as well as in the curriculum. And for another reason is that environment education is increasingly seen as a vital tool in establishing the ground rules by which the environment could be more effectively managed in the future. Now, what could be the objectives of environment education? The objectives of incorporating environment education into the school curriculum can be set by like to make children aware of the nature of the relationship between humanity and the environment on which it depends. Another point could be to impart knowledge and skills to understand and solve environment and development related issues. Another point could be to enable children to acquire the attitudes and motivations leading to sound discussions and civic actions for the improvement and protection of the environment and its quality. Now, environment education has many features also at the primary level, like it should basically have a child-centered approach involving interaction by children. The activities should be interesting, relevant, based on our daily life experience of the child is the most important thing. The age level of the student, their maturity, all these points should be seen before applying to this particular thing. It should enhance the nature, curiosity of the child. It should help the child in developing attitudes and qualities, for example, self-confidence, spirit of inquiry, initiative and courage to ask questions. It should encourage the child to think of solutions to problems in his or her day-to-day life. It should develop the desired skills in the children. It should help the child to develop logical thinking also, and it also helps the child to take active interest and participate in solving some simple problems in a limited way. It should also help a child in developing open-mindedness and perseverance. It should enable the child to adopt an environment-friendly lifestyle. Now, there are many teaching methodologies and variety of teaching methodologies can be used for effectively integrating environment dimensions into the existing curriculum system with minimal demands. No matter what the situation, the teaching learning experience can be enhanced only by the teachers. For example, teacher can use games, demonstrations, performing arts, classroom displays, art and craft, creative writing, exhibitions, creative expressions, all these are the examples of these activities, and these can be constructed for life situations, which becomes a meaningful means for engaging of the learners. The big challenge is to use imagination and innovative in selecting for many activities and approaches that can motivate students and take them for awareness to action. Now here, teacher role is also very important when she is introducing all these activities. As an environmental education teacher, it is important that we creatively utilize the immediate environment, which is our school and community of the child, as the learning lab. The major advantage of this area are like it takes care of the fact that environment is a composite subject. And it is so because our student is all the time operating in the real life situations. And hence, it is observing and learning in a manner which is seamless and not limited by the boundaries of science and only social science. Learning through real life process and experiences is an effective way of learning among children. By using school and local environment as the learning ground, we as a teacher ensure that our students follow their naturally preferred way of learning, thereby enhancing their learning, knowledge, and competence. It is always said that learning made from immediate environment and from real life experiences remains with the individual for a longer period of time. And this is always with us also, as a teachers also, because when we see a real life experiences, when we see real life activities, real life exposures, real life experiences, so that always give a long impression in our mind rather than just having or listening to the lecture mode. So also, all such learning are easier to be recalled and applied in the later stage of life, because we always used to remember that whatever we have done by our hands or whatever we have see the real life experience, they always, we can always recall them and we can always apply it in our any stage of the life. Bring in social context, encourage cooperation and collaboration based learning within and outside of the class is very, very important. Now, known to unknown and concrete to abstract, these two slogans we have been listening from long. So in the earlier years, it is said that it is more effective to ensure that the new concepts and information is explained in relation to the known one. It is so because during this period, the ability to learn abstract concepts is rather limited. So thus, new information is recognized and understood by the child in relation in child in relation to an existing one. When an appropriate connections and linkages are made in the child's mind about its own immediate experiences, the child is enabled to understand more abstract or sophisticated concepts and arguments later. An example of this form of current environmental education syllabus is the theme on the plants. Traditionally, the concept of the plants is introduced to young students or young children by providing explanations on typical part of a plant. But however, in the current syllabus, keeping in the mind the development and the progression of the concepts from concrete to abstract, the concept of the plant is first introduced to the theme of the food, which is familiar, starting with what plants do children eat and what part of a plant do they eat, etc. Now, there are many advantages of this design in environmental education, like children learn from their environment through their environment and locate new learnings on a tested and well-developed ground. Now, this pedagogy strategy of designing real life example in the classroom leads to the effective transformation of environment education. It has several advantages. The first one is local specific examples become an effective way of teaching learning environmental education. Since environment begins with me and with my immediate surroundings, this approach of learning about environment education ensures effective results. Environmental education concepts get located in the environment, social and cultural context of a child, ensuring that you are not alienating him from the reality. Rather, you are helping the child to connect information in the textbook with that of her own life and surroundings. And this helps we as a teacher to teach environmental education contextually. Now, thematic approach. The syllabus for environmental education basically for class 3rd to 5th is thematic in approach rather than being structured around the individual topics. It is woven around 6 common themes: family and friends, food, shelter, water, travel and things we make and do. Now, these themes provide real-life links to the children's daily experiences. This begins by helping children to explore their immediate self to include his or her family environment and to expand gradually to include neighborhood, their locality, their country, and the world. Thematic organization of content in environmental education helps dissolve the conventional subject boundaries created in the formal education system. And it also encourages the learners to realize the linkages between the various subjects. So, thematic structure of the content in environment education cuts across the boundaries of several disciplines such as social sciences, sciences, languages, history, geography, civics, etc. And developing in children an interdisciplinary perspective, contributions of various disciplines to understanding environment and environmental problems and their solutions, because this is related to our life and lifestyles. Thus, environmental education is an interdisciplinary study of how humans interact with their environment, physical, biological, social, and culture. As a teacher, let us try to understand the implications of the thematic organization of concepts for teaching learning process. Let us take the example of water. If water was to be taught and learned through discrete subject boundaries of science and social science, perhaps one would need to look through the geography textbooks to understand the distribution of water on Earth. Now, to understand how the earlier generation assessed and used water, one would need to browse through the textbooks of social science. Then to understand the need of water for plants and animals, you would be required to refer the biology textbooks. But in case of environmental studies, various aspects of water, scientific, social and historical, are dealt within a common large theme and not necessarily as physics and chemistry of water. The content of environment education explore the different dimensions of certain themes like food, water, shelter, etc. So these discussions dealing with real issues of children by connecting them with the real experiences at home, neighbors, community, etc. So such connections are real life experiences and situations and plays a major role in developing and fostering lifelong attitudes, values and conviction of actions and behaviors towards environment and its conservation. Thus, environment education is one of the most necessary part of the education system nowadays, and it talks about everything in totality, all disciplines, all sections of the society, and it also advocates education for the environment and from the environment. Environment education is not only value education as regards environment, but it also a life skill education, as it encourages children to develop knowledge, ideas, values, attitude about the world and how it works, and learn to communicate and collaborate with other children and adults in the environment. So a good environmental studies learning environment must encourage dialogues, debates, questionings, with strengthening analytical and critical thinking skills among learners are very, very critical during environmental education teaching. To conclude, as a teacher, I must say that we have to realize that our role is that of a facilitator and co-learner, who not only encourages children to learn by experiencing, exploring and discovering, but also learn with her learner. A good teacher must be sensitive that values form integral part of environment education, and hence she must be able to deal with the values in the classroom in a very, very prudent manner. So this is all about the role of the teacher in environmental education. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you.